The name Daddy Longlegs could be in reference to a few different animals, so for clarity's sake, we're discussing animals belonging to the order Opiliones. They're also known as Granddaddy Longlegs, and in the scientific community, they're often called Harvestmen. But I've always known them as Daddy Longlegs, so that's what we're going with today. Daddy Longlegs might look like spiders, but they aren't. Daddy Longlegs are incapable of producing silk, and they lack fangs and venom, which are all features found in spiders. They also have two or fewer eyes, while most spiders have eight. Plus, spiders have to eat their food by turning it into liquid and sucking it up. But Daddy Longlegs can chew their food. How polite! Daddy Longlegs are mostly nocturnal scavengers who eat flies, roly-polies, plants, fruits, and dead animals. Though some species do hunt, and some also come out during the day. Daddy Longlegs also appear to have a single oval-shaped body, while spiders distinctly have an abdomen and cephalothorax. But really, it's just that Daddy Longlegs lack that defined waist found in spiders. They both have eight legs though, and that can really throw a person off. But even their legs are different. See, in the case of many spider species, if a leg is lost to a predator, the spider is able to regrow the lost limb. But Daddy Longlegs can do no such thing. When a Daddy Longlegs sacrifices its leg to a predator in order to make a hasty escape, that leg is gone for good. They're still able to get by without it, though. Some predators who may be snatching Daddy's long legs are birds, reptiles, amphibians, and insects, such as wasps and ants. I can't really imagine why anything would try to eat something that has a quarter-inch body length and pegs for legs, but I suppose the nearly inch-long species probably offer better fare. To keep predators away, Daddy Longlegs will gather in large groups. There are a couple of theories as to why this may be beneficial to them. One reason is simply safety in numbers. Groups of Daddy Longlegs will come together and create movement as a group, which might confuse predators. Plus, if the group is attacked, there's a higher chance for an individual to escape. I'm doubting a predator would want to attack a group of Daddy Longlegs anyway, though. Daddy Longlegs are able to secrete a noxious chemical to deter opposers. Oh, that reminds me. The chemical they can produce is not harmful to humans, and as we mentioned before, Daddy Longlegs do not have fangs or venom. So that whole concept about Daddy Longlegs being the most venomous spiders in the world is totally false. They're harmless to us. In fact, in many parts of the world, they are considered a symbol of good luck, and killing them brings about misfortune. Better watch where you step. Daddy Longleg reproduction habits are what set them apart from other arachnid members. While they are able to reproduce via parthenogenesis, for the most part they reproduce via direct fertilization, and as far as we can tell, they've been doing this for more than 400 million years. The female may lay her eggs immediately after copulation or even months later, though they're usually laid in cooler months to hatch in the spring. Something else that sets Daddy Longlegs apart from many arthropods are that the parents, males included, in some species, take care of the eggs. It's rare that arthropod males have any involvement in egg rearing, so it's neat that the ones that perform the role as a daddy take on that moniker. Most Daddy Longlegs only live about a year, but some species do live longer. There are more than 6,600 species of Daddy Longlegs, and they live everywhere, except that one place nothing on this show seems to live. Except the penguins, and the Arctic terns. There are always the birds. Preferred environments of Daddy Longlegs include forests, caves, grasslands, mountains, wetlands, even trees. And many species require humidity for survival. They're easily affected by changes to their environment, so some species, especially cave-dwelling species, are listed as endangered. Of course, with so many species to account for, we don't have population statistics for a vast majority of the Opiliones order. Still, it's important to know that we should try not to disturb our environment as best we can, since we share this planet with everything living on it, big and small. For more facts on Daddy Longlegs, check out the links in the description. Have you ever seen one of these animals? Let us know in the comments. Give a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time on Animal Fact Files.